Eric, you are still watching Saloon Talk, and I'm still your girl, Sabaria. We are still tackling the topic of gifts. Hey, so you who's there, you're giving someone something that they do not want, but they have to accept it just because you've they're accepting your gesture, because it's very rude to decline a gift, whether small or big. But my guests in the building are going to clarify on these things, because we have both the gents and the beautiful ladies. We're going to get the perspective of the women and the men. So that was a story that was going on all over Facebook and Instagram. There is a guy, he posted on his handles, and he was like, I have a girlfriend, and my birthday was just a week ago, and she bought me flowers of worth 50,000. I accepted them, but in my mind I was like, why couldn't she give me like a 50K? Because he goes on and says that she would have given me like a 50K, I go buy what I want. Cutty flowers, how do you gift a man flowers? Like, literally. So that comes to what we are talking about, the topic of gifting. Women are always expecting a certain type of gift. They always want, if you're gifting a woman these days, a boy no more, some LS wig, you have to get her like a very nice handbag. And nowadays handbags are expensive, they're no longer cheap like they used to go. You go and find like a handbag of 15. No, and these days even 15 handbags are no longer there. And then men are always expecting, men actually don't really expect gifts, by the way. So let's start from Flex. What is your opinion on these girls that always be want to, like, they always want to be gifted very, very huge gifts, and when you bring something small, they throw tantrums, they treat you like you don't exist?
I think, first of all, the guy who was disappointed in the flowers, it depends also, he gets the flowers the same with 50K, because maybe you find the babe knew he had some situation going on, and that 50K would help him, and now he's seeing flowers that he's not going to, with them. You get, maybe you just post them and that's it. You get, and 50K is gone with just some few likes. But of course, but at the same time, the gesture of flowers, I think, is really important. It's not about some things you give, even if you know it's perishable, like a cake,
The smile flowers, it brings to someone.
Yeah, it's not about that. It's going to, you're going to keep it or something like that, but just the whole gesture of that. So I think that's also still there, but depends the situation and who the person is.
Yeah,
you get.
Yeah, true.
But the thing you've also asked about the ladies and the gifts they want nowadays, obviously they'll have high expectations, because social media has changed things. They're gifting people Range Rovers, they're gifting people with trips to Dubai, they're giving like crazy. You get, so someone is seeing what other guys are doing. You already see those captions from babes, but God, when me, what? you get all those kind of captions.
And we're always finding people cursing on social media. You people with your flowers, yet they haven't gotten anything.
Yeah. So that whole vibe of how they're seeing it online, definitely they're also going to expect you to step up a bit. They're also going to expect something different. It may not be like a Range Rover, obviously, or whatever, but they would expect you to do something that's very different, and you don't blame them, I guess. So.
Okay. So, Lina, I'm going to give you a different question, because basically almost all the questions have literally the same answers. Do you really think social media has influenced the way gifts are being handed out these days?
Actually, yes, I do. There's a lot going on social media. There are so many people dating via social media. You find a couple on media and you're like, yeah, mama, they're doing things. Yeah. But you don't know what happens behind the scenes. And you really want to be like them. Probably your boyfriend is not doing this for you, or you're seeing them receiving flowers, cars and what. But at the end of the day, which kind of relationship are you in? Who is this person you're dating? Because the person may be, let's say I'm dating a man whose capacity I know. I don't expect him to get me a car if we are struggling.
True, very, very true. Yeah.
Though I don't expect him to also relax knowing that, my girlfriend understands me. Yes. So speaking of personally, I'm not a person of flowers. It is very romantic. But of course, when you bring it, I won't refuse it. I believe you can give me something better than flowers. These are things that you're going to bring for me today, and I'll smile, I get excited, but it won't wither out.
Remember, yeah.
Yes, it's not something I remember. I believe in something tangible. Get me that nice bag, or get me the shoes, or what. Or take me on a vacation, I'll have the memories. But flowers, I don't know if I'm being too backwards, but to me, flowers, no. But of course, when he brings it, I'll appreciate.
Obviously. What about those who bring you plastic flowers? Because those are tangible. You know, they right. never get spoiled.
Well, I'll go back to the first statement. Gifting someone is out of the heart. So whether you bring me plastic or, you know, natural or anything,
the thought
of it, there are still flowers. At the end of the day, I've received a gift. Other than, you know, it's your birthday and you're getting nothing.
Yeah, so gifting. That's really true. I've been seeing people all over social media because social media actually is different from real life. It's like most cases, like 70%.
Yeah, the grass is greener on social media. Trust
yeah.
me.
Because I won't even say I have a friend. I'll say specifically on my birthday. I am a type of person. Sometimes it's all about how the person relates with people. I'm a type of person who doesn't really talk. I have a lot of friends. I should not really call them friends, but they are people I talk to. You know, they're not like I can call them when I'm in trouble and they come. I'm an introvert. I'm not really a type of person that like over wants to be with people all the time. Every time they go to bars, I tag along. I don't know. I'm not that type of person. So I've been having this type of friends whereby they post on social media that they're living the luxurious life. But in actual sense, even those flowers that they have gotten, the chocolates, they were gifting them to themselves. Like, you find someone and then you ask her, oh, where did this come from? Oh, some boyfriend. Kumbe, there is no one. She just wanted to, like, put her life on social media. What do you think to such people that want to fake life on social media just to show people that their life is perfect?
Fake it till you make it. Yeah, I guess.
Right. Fake it till you make That's it. What... But the people you're talking about, I don't know, you're talking about your friends.
Yeah.
Most of your friends
no,
are...
Me, I don't fake life, but my friends...
Yeah, okay. Yeah. Auntie, most of those friends you're talking about are maybe socialites, and that's work. Which they get, right?
Not really, because I'm also a socialite. I'm talking about these people who are like, they just like camera. There are people that like camera. They're not socialites, but they just love camera.
That's what you say, fake it till you make it. That's work.
I think you've seen even some socialites gifting themselves cars.
Yeah.
You know,
oh, wow.
And yet that car is going back to the bond, you know?
But why? Like, why fake? Because everybody's...
Hype.
No, people are going to
Everyone's
see you and go on a border,
it,
yeah. by the way.
That's what makes them happy. Because if she's gifting herself and she knows it's going to work for her...
The news.
Then she'll be happy. She's going to do that.
Hey, that's true. It's everybody's mindset. Everybody's...
Then those ones who are saying are not socialites, maybe some of them just do it for...
For the fun
to
of
create
it.
To create maybe that aura around them that maybe people like them, you know, to put the price up, you know, to show that they're different...
But I actually feel gifting yourself is actually okay. Because
How? How? You know the feeling of someone gifting you and you gifting yourself?
Kati, then that person gifting you, they have to make sure they know what you want for you to value. Like, all it again, but you won't value that gift. That's not even a gift. Your worst gift.
Also, actually, these people that be like, oh, I'm going to, oh, your birthday gift, I ordered for it, but it took long to come. And then after a month also, you don't want to obviously ask them, hey, where's my gift? Because that's like kajanja, eh? But then the person still, every time he sees you at work, he still tells you, oh, your gift is coming. The year ends, nothing. Next year comes, oh, I forgot. Don't worry, I'll give it on from last year. Like,
first of all, you have to have hope. Which they get, eh?
Yeah.
And that person telling you that I'm giving you a gift, just know the sting nigger that is going to get to your heart. Which they get, eh? So who would they? Don't be bad.
Yeah.
Eh? Okay. You understand?
Wow. Okay. To jab be banja, we shall be. And by the way, all of those, my birthday was last year. It's about to come. Those who promised me gifts and you have a cheater, hey. We shall talk about those things later. So, Lina, what's your concept when it comes to such people?
You mentioned something about gifting yourself. And I'm going to ask you one question. How would you feel if you took yourself on a coffee date for yourself?
But I always do. That is why it is so annoying to me, because no one wants to take me. I always take myself, I buy myself things. Like, for once in a while, I want someone to come and give me something. Like, me, I always tell people, by the way, if you're looking for something to gift women, look for the things that they really need. Not want, but need. Now, like, for example, wigs. Nowadays, we have these nice lace wigs. buy a chick, even if it's 1 week, because wigs are expensive. Wigs are really expensive. Buy one. Trust me. You'll never see me stalk. You'll never see me say anything wrong about. I'll always praise your name. But people always always be like, well, I'm going to gift someone. Then when the gifting day comes, they become lazy. Is it because you don't really carry that much importance in their lives, or?
Well, that is a point, carrying importance in someone's life. And also, do you also gift them? Do you give out the same way you would want to be given out, given to? You get it. It all goes back. Because if let's say I have a friend and every time on her birthdays, I don't give her anything. Oh, it all ends to happy birthday, hey, enjoy your day. You know what people do. All you keep typing is thank you, thank you, thank you. And then on your birthday, you'd want to be gifted by the same person. Really? So I feel like what you give out is what you receive. Because you don't expect to receive gifts from people, and yet for you don't.
But that is very right. But I'm still going to give examples, because when it comes to gifting process, I have a lot of friends who are being gifted all the single time. So about what you've said, that is very true. But there are those people that, oh, banaba bombo na reza, I don't know. Is that how they call it in Luganda, bombo and reza? Yeah. You find that a girl, on her friend's birthday, she's always just wishing them a happy birthday. Because not like, let me say she has, her financial status is not really to the point of what she wants to gift you. Like, she wants to gift you, but she can't afford it. But you find, like, she's on her birthday, she receives gifts from people, even people that she rarely talks to, just because they like her, they like her vibe, they still send gifts. She's at the salon, they're sending gifts. And then you, who has a lot of friends who say they care about you, you're not even getting a campaign, just a campaign. Like, what's going on in Uganda?
But do you also realize the people who ask for gifts?
I was going to say.
Yes.
Well, the people who make their lists, yes, and they send their list around. Mm-hmm. You know, they're like, this is what I want for my birthday, you know. So someone's going to be like, oh, hey, I think we've sent this around. But you've seen this around on social media and all that.
Just give you. So the trick is you can post what you want.
But I think the person who puts out those lists, go ahead and do it, because you're saying you don't want flowers, right? You prefer shoes. So you put your list and say, I want shoes, I want this. You get what I'm saying?
But then also,
but people are doing that a lot.
Yeah.
Yeah.
All right, let us first go for a commercial break. When we come back, we're still talking about the gifting process. Is it important? Is it not important? And what impact does it have on the people, you who's gifting and you who's receiving the gifts? Let us come back. You are still watching Salon Talk.